How's it, guys? I'm Gus, the African plant understanding here on the banks of the Runde River in Gonarezhou National Park in Zimbabwe. I'm standing right here in front of a beautiful stand of acacia, or should I say Vachellia xanthophloea, the fever tree. This is part two in my series on the fever tree. Last episode I talked a little bit generally about the plant, the tree, and now I'm going to talk specifically about its medicinal properties. And in fact, I'm going to focus right in. So it's been used in traditional medicine in a wide range of ways. The gum is used, the bark is used, sometimes made into a tea, sometimes consumed in other ways. But I'm going to focus on the phytochemical properties of this tree. There are three phytochemicals, they're all related, that are all of interest. And they are catechins, catecholamines, and catecholamines. So let me just talk you through each one of those one by one, and then you can see why this is such a remarkable tree that has a wide variety of uses in traditional and potentially and actually in modern medicine. So the first one is the catechins. So catechins are found in a lot of different fruit. Fruit that I've focused on before that also is quite high in catechin is the sausage tree Kigelia africana. So what a catechin does, a catechin is an antioxidant and a free radical scavenger. And it is very, very, very effective and potent in that regard. Second compound is catechol. Now catechol is found in lots and lots of different fruit, and it's responsible for the browning effect, for example, in an apple when you cut it open. So what happens when you cut an apple open, that fruit has been damaged, and in order to protect itself, it releases catechol. What that does is there are antimicrobial properties in the catechol that protect the fruit from any further damage as a result of being exposed. So that's catechol. Now let's go on to catecholamine. So you've heard the phrase brain chemistry, which simply signifies the enormous amount of chemical activity that's going on inside the brain at any one time. Particularly important in that chemistry is the role of hormones, which I think we all know, and catecholamines are part of that. So catecholamines are molecules that include dopamine and adrenaline, which is interesting. So what has been explored in terms of potential medicinal use of bark extract of Vachellia xanthophloea has been some kind of treatment to help brain chemistry disorders, particularly ADHD, irregular sleep patterns, and so on. It's kind of a new thing. There's still a lot of work going on, and it's by no means the only plant that has catecholamine in it. But it is interesting, and it does validate some of the traditional uses. I could go on and on about this tree, just like any other in this family. Of course, the Vachellia family, or what we used to refer to as the acacia family, all particularly known for the fact that they have spines and prickles, but they all also have exudates, and it's in that gum that a lot of the goodness is stored. So it's also, by the way, high fiber, very, very, very good for your digestive system. And is traditionally used to treat gastrointestinal and digestive disorders as well, which is not at all surprising given the role of fiber in promoting the growth of beneficial bacteria in your intestinal microbiome. I think that's enough science for one day. I'm enjoying this beautiful, beautiful day. You know, Gonarezhou National Park is famed for very high temperatures, and we're here in midwinter and it's cool and beautiful, and I could be out here all day long. Anyway, guys, I've really enjoyed talking to you. I'm Gus, the African Plant Hunter. If we haven't met before, you can see plenty more on my YouTube channel, Facebook, Instagram, africanplanthunter.com. Please do join me again. I would love to see you. And if you want to see more on this amazing place, Gonarezhou National Park, please check out their website, Gonarezhou Conservation Trust. They are phenomenal. Gonarezhou.org. All right, guys, take it easy. I will catch you later. Cheers. Bye. Thank you.